works among men are awesome. Father, this morning we are fallen from your works. It is not for your grace and mercy. Father, you don't know where you could have been today. Father, this first Sunday of the year 2022, we say thank you. We say thank you. Father, we bless you. Jehovah, we glorify you. Father, we do not know what awaits us the year 2022. Lord, by faith, we stand on your promises. The promises that are yes and amen. And the Lord has been faithful in the years before. Lord,
you'll
be faithful to us even the years to come. We submit to your Lordship. We pray, Lord, just take preeminence in our lives. Take over our lives. Take over our careers. Take over our businesses. Take over our marriages. Take over everything
concerning us.
Father, glorify yourself. Take over this nation. Lord, we don't know what awaits us in the political arena. But Lord, we choose to trust in you. Because you are a strong tower. Where we the righteous run and we find refuge. Our Father, don't know what awaits the students. As they open the schools. Our Father, in the privacy. Previous days we had stresses among them. Lord, a lot of the devastation we caused in our schools. But Father, we look to you. Be merciful to us. Lord, show yourself to be strong. Glorify yourself. Bless you this morning. Father, as we sit at your feet, instruct us. Father, as your word tells us in Psalms chapter
8,
Father, your desires instruct us.
Lord,
sometimes you found us to be stubborn, like a mule. But Lord, I pray this year we shall be willing to obey your word. We shall be willing to do that which you want us to do. Because your word is established both in heaven and on earth. And by it, Lord, you have the hope for the future. Father, help us. Bless us together. In Jesus' name. They will say Amen. Standing on the promises, as my King, through eternal ages, let His praises sing. Glory in the highest, and we shout and sing. Standing on the promises of God.
Standing on the promises of Christ, my King, through eternal ages, let His praises be. Glory in the highest, and we shall not see. Standing on the promises of God, standing on the promises of God, I say, standing, 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 I am standing on.
that I
yes and amen.
Amen.
Can never fail. Yes. They can never fail.
Yes.
They are found.
Yes.
They are eternal.
Yes.
May God be to us in Jesus' name.
Yes.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Please tell your neighbor. Turn to your neighbor. Happy New Year. Happy New Year.
Explain
to God, what does the year 2022, what we do? What is our theme? What is the direction you are giving us? The Lord put so heavy in our hearts that He wants us to build the walls of our lives.
Tell your
neighbor, neighbor, the year of rebuilding the broken walls. The year of rebuilding. There is perfect re. Kwanza kujenga tena na ile hali ya ulijenga kama ulijenga kwa sasa imebomoka, unaanza tena. Praise the Lord. One of the issues that God was telling us the last 2 to 3 years,
kati ya mambo ambayo ametuambia miaka karibu 3 iliyopita,
when the COVID-19 came,
wakati COVID-19 ilikuja,
none of us have had very unprecedented lives.
When we tumekuwa na maisha ambayo kidogo hatukutarajia.
We have had devastating times at family level, at workplace, and everywhere.
Tumekuwa na wakati mgumu katika viwango vya jamii, maana mpaka sana sehemu tofauti.
Many of us, we lost our loved ones.
Wengi wetu tukapoteza wapendwa.
The people that were intimate to us.
Watu ambao walikuwa karibu sana nasi.
You know, it's easier to, you know, it's manageable in counseling. We talk about mourning period.
It's easier to manage
a situation when it has been prolonged for some time. But COVID was very strange. Somebody sick in the morning.
Lakini COVID ilikuwa ajabu. Mtu mgonjwa siku.
Around 11 is done.
Saa 5 imekwisha.
Then the government came out with restriction that you have to do away with the dead body. The next few hours.
Serikali ikapeana mwelekeo kwamba kwa masaa machache mimi hiyo imezikwa.
It's not easy.
Haikuwa rahisi.
People are still devastated today.
Watu bado wana shida hata leo.
I know families that have gone through tough times.
Ndio jamii ambazo zimepitia wakati mgumu.
Some of us we had lost our pressure from within and without.
Wengine wetu tulikuwa tumepoteza tumaini ndani na nje.
Others went through what you call internal conflicts among themselves.
Wengine wakapitia ile kila ambacho tunaita ugomvi wa ndani wenyewe kwa wenyewe.
No, in one of the courses we did about conflict management.
Katika moja ya masomo tulizungumza kuhusu kushughulikia ugomvi.
It's easier to do external to manage external conflicts.
Ni rahisi sana kushughulikia ugomvi wa nje.
Than from outside. Because you can call the parties to table.
Maana naweza ita watu wengine wahusike
wasikoshughulikie. And negotiate among them.
Kisha wazungumze kuhusu jambo hilo.
One of the most challenging experiences in life.
Lakini kati ya matukio ajabu katika maisha.
Is what you call the internal conflicts.
Kila ambacho tunaita magomvi ama ugomvi.
Things that are within you.
Vitu ambavyo viko ndani mwako.
You get to a level of frustration.
Unafika mahali ambapo unakuwa na shida.
You don't know what to do.
Haujui ufanye nini.
You have nobody to talk to.
Hauna mtu wa kuzungumza naye.
Sometimes the people you talk to, you feel they're not giving you the answer you want.
Wakati mwingine unazungumza na watu lakini hawakupatii jibu hilo sawa.
Because there is a way you're looking at the whole situation.
Kwa sababu kuna namna unavyotazamia ile jambo.
And many of us suffer frustrations.
Wengi wetu tunakuwa na shida.
Some of us we were hurt.
Wengine wetu tukaumizwa.
Some of us we were wounded.
Wengine wetu tukajeruhiwa.
The truth is the years that are past.
Kweli ni kwamba miaka iliyopita
may not be better off than the years that are coming.
Wewe isiwe nzuri kama vile miaka inayokuja.
May not be better off than the years that are coming.
When is we born? Kwa miaka inayokuja mbele.
There could be bad social experience as individuals.
When kuna vita tutaona sisi wenyewe.
But the good news is.
Lakini habari njema ni kwamba.
Isaiah 43 verses 2.
Isaiah 43 mstari wa pili.
The Bible says.
Inasema.
When you pass through the waters.
Unapopita katika maji.
I will be with you.
Nitakuwa nawe.
And through the rivers.
Katikati ya mito,
they shall not overflow.
Haitakugarikisha.
When you walk through the fire,
unapopita katikati ya moto,
you shall not be burned out.
Hautaunguzwa.
Nor shall the flames scorch you.
Wala miale ya moto haitakuchoma.
Verse 3.
Mstari wa 3.
For I am the Lord.
Maana mimi ni Bwana.
Your God.
Mungu wako.
The Holy One of Israel.
Mtakatifu wa Israeli.
Your Savior.
Mwokozi wako.
Says, I will not leave you.
Sitakuacha.
So remember, God will never leave you. Talk to neighbor, talk to neighbor, neighbor. You may go through. The Bible has also said you may stand. Say you may go through. You may go through. Talk to neighbor, what you are going through, what you are going through is just temporal. Please talk to neighbor, talk to neighbor, neighbor. It is temporal. You are going through the waters. Says, I will be with you. Now the question is, when you look at that verse,
it
says, this quote verse says, when you go through the waters, I will be with you. Now, it comes down to the rivers. Now, what is the difference between the waters and the rivers?
It
says, the rivers, they shall not overflow you.
Sema mito haita kugarikisha.
Many waters.
Maji mengi.
I thought the rivers would be deeper than the rivers. I thought the waters would be deeper than the rivers.
Na wanafoka labda maji anaweza kuwa ndani sana kuliko mito.
Now somebody is following closely.
Mtu ananifuata kwa karibu.
Says you will go through.
Nasema utapiti.
Says when.
Sema ujapo.
He doesn't say if.
I say it ikiwa
sasa. When you go through.
Sema utakapopitia.
In other words, waters.
Kumaanisha maji.
Rivers.
Mito.
And the fires.
Pamoja na mioto.
Are part of life.
Ni sehemu ya maisha.
Did you not hear me?
Hujanisikia.
Did you hear me?
Umenisikia.
You know, many believers, when we go through this, we say God has forsaken us.
Wengi tunapopitia haya, nasema kwamba Mungu ametusahau.
He says, when?
Anasema ujapo.
In other words, they will come.
Kumaanisha kwamba vita kuja.
He says, the good news we have,
lakini habari njema tunayo,
that says I will be with you.
Sema nitakuwa nawe.
In the waters,
katika maji.
In the fire,
katika moto.
In the rivers,
katika mito.
I will be with you.
Nitakuwa nawe.
There will be burning.
Nitakuwa vitu vinashika.
Doesn't say that I will stop them from burning.
Hajasema kwamba atanizuia.
Says there will be burning.
Sema vitawaka.
But the flames will not scorch you.
Lakini makaa ya moto haitakunguza.
Tell me never the flames will not scorch you.
Jirani yangu, makaa ya moto haitakunguza.
Tell me never the flames will not scorch you.
Makaa ya moto haitakunguza.
Say it will not be burnt.
Sema kwamba hutachomwa.
You shall not be scorched by the flames.
Sema kwamba hautaunguzwa kwa
moto. I say 2022.
Nasema 2022.
The flames shall not scorch in Jesus.
Miale ya moto haitakuchoma katika Yesu.
The flames of life shall not scorch in Jesus.
Miale ya maisha haitakuchoma katika Yesu.
The flames of life shall not scorch in Jesus.
Miale ya maisha haitakuchoma katika Yesu.
Says you will go through the fire.
Sema utapitia katika moto.
He says when you walk through.
Anasema ujapopita.
You walk.
Unatembea.
Whenever you walk through.
Yeah, you're not telling
me that you will walk through.
Unapitia katika.
And look at your neighbor, tell your neighbor you will walk.
Sema utatembea.
You will not sit.
Hautakaa.
You will not stand.
Hautasimama.
You will not lie.
Hautalala.
God says, you will walk through.
Sema kwamba utapita ndani utatembea.
You will walk through the fire.
Utapita katikati ya moto.
You will walk through the fire.
Utapita katikati ya moto.
And you shall not be bound by the flames.
Lakini hautaongozwa kwa miale.
For I am the Lord.
Maana mimi ni Bwana.
The Holy One of Israel.
Mtakatifu wa Israeli.
For I shall be with you.
Maana nitakuwa nawe.
May the Lord be with you in the year 2022.
Bwana awe nawe mwaka
huu. May the Lord be with you in this year in Jesus' name.
Bwana awe nawe mwaka huu katika jina la Yesu.
The truth is,
ukweli ni kwamba
the COVID pandemic may still be there.
Janga la corona huenda lingalipo.
And we may enter a situation where we have to live by it.
Na tutafika mahali ambapo tutaishi kwa hilo.
We must be willing to adjust.
Lazima tukuwe tayari kubadilika.
Tell you about willing to adjust.
Kuwa tayari kubadilika kidogo.
I know that people don't want to take the vaccine.
I know kuna watu ambao hataki kuchukua kinga macho.
But I tell you, improve your immunity.
Lakini nasema kwamba jaribu kuboresha hali yako ya afya.
Tell you never improve your immunity.
Boresha hali yako ya kinga.
Give the traditional bloggers.
Wachana na mambo ya kitamaduni.
Eat.
Kula mboga ya kienyeji.
Eat that.
Kula.
Eat a lot of potassium.
Kula vya kienyeji sana.
They'll boost your immunity.
Vitasaidia katika kinga ya mwili.
But those who want to go for vaccines.
Lakini kwa wale ambao wanaenda kwa chanjo.
I'm told those who want for the first one can go and boost.
Wale ambao walienda ya kwanza wanaweza enda muongezee tena.
I don't know for how long you boost it. But God will help us.
Sijui itakusaidia vipi lakini Mungu atakusaidia.
Somebody say amen.
Tuseme amen.
We must learn to live by it.
Lazima tujifunze kuishi kwa hiyo.
That's why first must may be part and parcel of it.
Ndio maana barakoa itakuwa sehemu ya maisha yako.
Not here, but
yes, tomorrow.
Yes,
here.
Praise the Lord. Many things are changing in the year 2022.
Mambo mengi yanabadilika mwaka huu.
One of the issues is life may be a little bit harder.
Kweli ni kwamba moja kwa moja ni kwamba maisha yatakuwa magumu,
because the supply chain globally is affected.
Maana ile hali ya kupeana vyakula katika ulimwengu inabadilika.
It's affected.
Inaathirika.
Things are never the same.
Mambo hayako sawa tena.
Some of the things you used to get for free.
Vitu ambavyo tulikuwa tunapata bure.
The nation that gave us for free are saying, no, it's not easy.
Mataifa ambayo tulikuwa tunapata bure yanasema
sasa it's tough.
Mambo ni magumu.
The travel restriction may be many.
Mambo yanakuwa mambo makatisa yanakuwa mengi. Usafiri unaweza kuwa na shida.
I pray that God will help us.
Naomba kwamba Mungu atatusaidia.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana asifiwe.
Many things may change globally.
Vitu vingi vitabadilika katika ulimwengu.
A lot of companies may continue closing.
Kampuni nyingi zitafunga.
Some may open up.
Zingine zitafunguliwa.
The climate change is rising.
Mabadiliko katika hali ya anga inabadilika pia.
The last 2 weeks of December we have experienced a unique flu.
Majuma mawili ya December tumeona hali fulani ya homa.
Just unique.
Hali fulani ambayo
temperatures are high.
Hali ya anga mahali yote
inakuwa body changing.
Mwili unabadilika.
No, the climate change has many effects coming around us.
Mabadiliko katika hali ya anga inatuathiri katika maisha.
I pray that the governments of Kenya and Africa will rise to the occasion.
Naamini kwamba serikali ya Kenya na Afrika itainuka kuingilia kati.
And be able to offer solutions to the climate change that's affecting us today.
Ili ilete suluhisho katika mabadiliko katika hali ya anga inayotuathiri leo.
There is a great change coming our way.
Kuna mabadiliko makuu yanakuja kwetu.
I see as the year advances.
Naona mwaka unaposonga mbele.
The pandemics and many diseases may come.
Wenda majanga yakaja mengi.
But in the midst of all this,
lakini kati ya vitu hivi vyote,
God is going to raise up men and women.
Mungu atainua wake kwa wake, wake kwa wame.
With ideas.
Wakiwa na mawazo.
That will be able to venture into the medical world.
Ambao wataingia katika ulimwengu wa kidaktari.
And be able to provide solution to some of the medicine, some of the pandemics we are going to experience.
Ili walete suluhisho kwa majanga ambayo tunayapitia.
Somebody not hear me.
Mtu hajanisikia.
There is inventions coming.
Kuna watu wanaingilia.
There are inventions coming.
Kuna watu wanaingilia.
Inventions wa uvumbuzi.
Uvumbuzi unaingilia, unakuja.
God is going to cause inventions to come.
Mungu atasababisha uvumbuzi kuja.
They may not be all doctors.
Wenda wote si madaktari.
They may be young graduates.
Wanaweza kuwa labda watu wadogo.
The God will give an idea.
Ambao Mungu atawapatia mawazo.
Solve the pandemics that you're going to experience as a globe.
Kuleta suluhisho katika majanga ambayo tutakumbana nayo katika ulimwengu.
Some of them may be Africans.
Wengi wanaweza kuwa labda wa Afrika.
Many of them may be Africans that God is going to anoint.
Wenda wengine ni Waafrika ambao Mungu atapaka mafuta.
Our sons and daughters.
Watoto wetu wa kike na wa
kiume. God is going to anoint.
Mungu anaenda kuwapaka mafuta.
And they'll have ideas in the medical world.
Watakuwa na mawazo katika ulimwengu wa kimataifa.
They will use the available resources.
Watatumia vitu ambavyo viko.
And as they venture into it,
wanapoingia ndani,
God is going to give them a solution to some of the problems.
Mungu atawapatia suluhisho kwa matatizo mengine.
I see God giving solutions.
Naona Mungu akipenda suluhisho.
Young men and women arriving.
Vijana wake wa waume wanainuka.
And ideas are being created.
Na mawazo yanaumbika.
They are going to involve in the laboratories to give solutions to the pandemics.
Wanaenda kuingia katika mahabara ili kuleta masuluhisho.
I see Africa rising beyond malaria.
Naona Afrika ikivuka dhidi ya malaria.
Because God is going to give ideas to young men.
Maana Mungu anapenda mawazo kwa vijana.
I see some of the pandemics that have established too many years.
Naona majanga mengine ambayo yametusumbua kwa muda mrefu.
In the next 5 years,
kwa miaka mitano ijayo,
God is going to give us a solution.
Mungu atatupa suluhisho.
I pray in the name of Jesus.
Naomba katika jina la Yesu.
The church will arise to pray.
Kanisa litainuka kuomba.
Will arise to prayer.
Tutainuka kwa kuomba.
God's purposes may be birth in the continent and in the world.
Makusudi ya Mungu yazaliwe katika bara na katika ulimwengu.
Many things are coming.
Mambo mengi yanakuja.
The church must arise to pray.
Kanisa lazima liinuke kuomba.
We must remain focused on the Great Commission.
Lazima tuzingatie katika mwito mkuu.
We must go out.
Lazima tuende kule nje.
Reach out to the people.
Kufikia watu.
Help people that are devastated Get hope.
We must
reach out to the vulnerable. The destitute. The orphans. The widows. We reach out to them. We give hope where there is hope. The church is the only solution.
Can this be solution?
Because many of the problems the Lord is going through. They cannot give a scientific problem. They cannot give a scientific solution. But God is going to give a spiritual solution to some of this.
However, it's not a solution. It's not like you can have a solution.
May God help us. I see great, witty inventions coming. I see some nations will go through trouble. Now, until some of them will go through a military coup. Many nations in Africa, and some of the nations in the continent of Africa, will go through many challenges. God wants us as a church
to pray.
God wants us to pray for the nations. Stop praying for yourself. Widen your scope of prayer. Invest in the continent. Pray for the nations of the continent of the world. Pray for
Madagascar.
Pray for the US. Pray for parts of Europe because of the year advances. The few years to come, this year from now. Some of them may experience a lot of floodings. Now our floodings may happen to nations. But we need to pray for them. That God may help us to avert the challenges that are coming to the nations. Rebuilding the broken walls. COVID and its challenges brought a lot of challenges to our lives. The man comes in at a time when Israel, the walls are broken. The nation that was called by the name of the Lord. The nation that God says, you are my special man and women. You are my people. A time comes when the walls are broken. The walls that were established by King David. For 40 years, Israel experienced peace.
Israel,
there were no battles. There were peace from the enemies. But a time came when David died. And his son Solomon reigned.
The
Bible says Solomon began so well. He was the wisest man on earth. And the kings of the world were coming to consult him. Everyone was happy. He was happy. James, live long the king of Israel. Live long the king Solomon.
But
then came when Solomon beyond his wisdom.
Lakini wakati ulikuja Sulemani akatumia bao.
He began to convert himself into the things of this world.
Akaanza kujiingiza kwa vitu vya ulimwengu huu.
Bible says he began to amass wealth.
Biblia inasema kwamba alianza kukusanya mali.
After amassing wealth,
baada ya kukusanya mali.
Bible says there has never been a wealthiest man on earth like King Solomon.
Biblia inasema kwamba hakujawahi kuona mtu tajiri kama mfalme Sulemani.
After amassing wealth,
baada ya kukusanya mali.
Solomon began getting into multiple marriages.
Sulemani akaanza kuingia katika ndoa za aina tofauti tofauti na ndoa nyingi.
And one of the greatest dangers in 2022 in our fight.
Na mojawapo ya hatari kuu katika mwaka
2022. Is the danger of greed.
Ni hatari ya ulafi.
Tell your neighbor greed.
Ambia jirani ulafi.
Tell your neighbor greed.
Ambia jirani ulafi.
Look at your neighbor. Tell your neighbor labor.
Ambia jirani.
The enemy you must fight in 2022 and above.
Adui ambao tunapigana mwaka huu na mwaka kile jayo.
Is the enemy called greed.
Ya adui tunamuita ulafi.
We must fight.
Lazima tupigane.
Wanting things that you don't need.
Vitu vya maana vizuri ambavyo hauhitaji.
And Solomon began to crave for wealth.
Kisha Sulemani akaanza kutafuta mali.
Solomon began to crave for women.
Akaanza kunyang'anya wanawake.
He had all kinds of women.
Alikuwa na kila aina ya wanawake.
He married 700.
Akaoa 700.
Beyond 700 he had didn't have any concubines.
Kando na 700 akakuwa na wengine 300.
I want men.
Mtu mmoja mwanamke.
I want men.
Na waonya wanaume.
Get rid of greed.
Achana na ulafi.
You must trust God to help us.
lazima tumtumaini Mungu kutusaidia.
In endeavors to meet your life needs. Katika harakati za kuimarisha ama kutafuta mahitaji ya kila siku, you must guard against greed.
Lazima ujikinge kutoka kwa ulevi.
Ukashulee Maseno Miracle.
Mwambie jirani,
greed,
ulevi
is a killer.
Ulevi.
Solomon went into marriages.
Suleiman akaingia katika ndoa tofauti.
He married many women.
Akaoa wanawake wengi.
Let me tell you men, when you are marrying these two women,
unapooa wanawake wawili,
or you have concubines,
ama kuna wanawake wa nje,
life is enjoyable.
Maisha ni mazuri.
But when the children come,
lakini watoto wanapokuja,
tutaelewa when the children come.
Ndio ndio watoto wanapokuja.
Tutaelewa when the children come.
Solomon
marries
Suleiman
has a son called Rehoboam and Jeroboam.
Suleiman anaoa anampata mtoto anaitwa Jeroboam na Jeroboam.
And Jeroboam takes over the northern kingdom.
Jeroboam anachukua ufalme wa juu.
And Rehoboam takes the south.
Kisha Rehoboam anachukua ufalme wa chini.
The kingdom that was supposed to be one,
ufalme ambao ulikuwa unafaa kwa moja,
it is now divided.
Sasa umegawanyika.
Devastation comes.
Kisha hali ngumu inakuja.
And Jeroboam establishes a golden altar in the north.
Kisha Jeroboam anatengeneza madhabahu ya dhahabu.
And he says, we must go back and do it.
Anasema kwamba tuende tuabudu.
And Israel went into idolatry.
Kisha Israeli ikaenda katika ibada ya sanamu.
Tena mema naipa na matusi ni masawaka.
Bilani dhambi ya pili ambayo lazima uishinde.
Is a sin of idolatry.
Ni dhambi ya kuabudu sanamu.
Is a sin of idolatry.
Ni dhambi ya kuabudu sanamu.
Go and vote.
Nenda mkapige kura.
But never idolize a man.
Lakini usifanye mtu kuwa sanamu yako.
Go and campaign.
Nenda ukafanye kampeni.
It is your right.
Ni haki zako.
But never involve in the idols of the men of the time.
Lakini usihusike katika ibada sanamu ya watu wa nyakati.
The Bible says the enemies took over the nation of Israel.
Nimesema kwamba adui akachukua usukani kwa taifa la Israel.
And Israel was taken into captivity.
Kisha Israeli ikachukuliwa mateka.
And after being taken into captivity,
baada ya kupelekwa katika mateka,
the Bible says,
sema
the enemy came,
adui akaja,
and the swords
akaribu,
that which they funded,
kile ambacho walidhamini,
they destroyed the temple,
wakaribu,
they took over the temple vessels,
wakaweka madhabahu mengine,
they took over,
walichukua
the temple vessels,
walitawala vyombo au wakachukua vyombo vya madhabahu,
they took over the temple vessels,
wakachukua vyombo vya
madhabahu, and after taking over the temple vessels,
wakachukua vyombo vya madhabahu,
Bible says,
Biblia inasema,
they took away,
wakachukua
the vessels,
zile vyombo,
and placed them at the altars of the enemy,
wakaviweka kwa madhabahu ya adui,
and they destroyed the altar,
wakaharibu madhabahu,
and Israel was no more.
Kisha Israeli haikuwepo.
They went into captivity for 70 years.
Wakaenda katika uhamisho kwa miaka 70.
The Bible says,
Biblia inasema,
and during the time of the 70 years,
siku hizo za miaka 70,
God began to raise up men like Daniel.
Mungu akaanza kuinua watu kama Daniel.
Daniel began to pray.
Daniel akaanza kuomba.
And God began to restore the people back to Jerusalem.
Kisha Mungu akaanza kurejesha vitu katika Israeli.
They began.
Wakaanza.
The first lot came.
Kisha kiomba cha kwanza,
the second lot followed.
Kiomba cha pili kikafika.
Nehemia.
Kisha Nehemia.
He is not born in Israel.
Hajazaliwa Israel. Hajazaliwa Yerusalemu.
He is born in Persia.
Amezaliwa kule Persia.
While he was serving the king.
Alipokuwa akitumikia mfalme.
The Bible says.
Biblia inasema.
A man called Hanani.
Mtu anaitwa Hanani.
Hanani came.
Hanani
says.
Anasema.
My brother.
Ndugu yangu.
The walls of Jerusalem.
Ukuta za Yerusalemu.
Are destroyed.
Zimeharibiwa.
The believers are trying to build the altar and the temple.
Wale waumini wanajaribu kujenga hekalu pamoja na madhabahu.
But one of the issues that is not there.
Lakini kitu kimoja ambacho hakiko.
The walls are broken.
Kuta zimevunjika.
Somebody say amen.
Mtu asema amen.
Somebody is following me closely.
Mimi nitanifuata kwa
karibu. That the walls are broken.
Kwamba kuta zimebomoka.
The walls are broken.
Kuta zimebomoka.
Now, when we talk about the walls,
tunapozungumza kuhusu
kuta, symbolize three things.
Inaonyesha vitu vitatu.
Number one,
kitu cha kwanza,
walls symbolize protection.
Ukuta unaashiria kinga.
They symbolize protection.
Ashiria kinga.
King David put walls.
Mfalme Daudi akajenga kuta.
I'm studying some archaeological documents about how like the wall was.
Najaribu kuangalia kusoma kuhusu vile ukuta ulikuwa mkubwa vipi.
Some manuscripts say they were 6 meters wide.
Wengine wanasema kwamba ukuta huo uzito wake au unene wake ulikuwa mita 6.
6 meters wide.
Can
you imagine a wall that's 6 meters wide? But even when the enemy throws a bullet, it cannot go through. Establish those walls. Some manuscripts say it was 9 meters. And there were tall. There were made of bricks and stones. They were giving protection to the nation. The walls symbolize number two.
Zinaashiria pili,
a culture.
Tamaduni.
Symbolize a culture.
Inaashiria tamaduni.
The walls symbolize a culture.
Kuta zinaashiria tamaduni.
Culture.
Tamaduni.
Every family must have a culture.
Kila familia tumeko na tamaduni.
Every man must have a culture.
Kila mtu lazima awe na tamaduni.
Africans have their own culture.
Afrika wako na tamaduni.
But we believers,
na sisi waumini,
we need to have our culture.
Lazima tuwe na tamaduni yetu.
The walls symbolize number three.
Kuta zaonyesha
security and posterity.
Usafi na uimarifu.
Ulinzi.
Ama usafi na ulinzi.
Security and posterity.
Usafi na ulinzi.
That's the way to secure.
Lazima wapewe
only the present generation.
Sio kwa kizazi hiki.
But also to secure the generation that are coming.
Pia kulinda kizazi ambacho kingekuja.
And David established.
Kisha Daudi akaimarisha.
Number four.
Nne.
The walls symbolize unique boundaries.
Ukuta unaonyesha mpaka ulio bora.
Unique boundaries established.
Mpaka ulio bora unaimarishwa.
There were boundaries demarcating. This is our place.
Kuna mpaka ambao unaonyesha kwamba hapa ni kwetu.
This is who we are.
Hapa hivi ndivyo tulivyo.
This is where we reach.
Hapa ndipo tunapofika.
This is how far as a believer I can go and I cannot go beyond there.
Hapa ndipo ninafika kama muumini asiwezi pita.
The moral boundaries.
Mipaka ya kitabia.
You establish.
Unaimarisha.
As a man.
Kama mtu.
That this is our goal.
Sema kwamba hapa ndipo
nitapata. I will interact with the opposite gender.
Nitahusiana na mtu wa
jinsia tofauti. But there is a level I cannot reach.
Lakini kuna kiwango
ambacho. Because there are boundaries.
Maana kuna mipaka.
Tell me there are boundaries.
Ajeje kuna mipaka.
There are boundaries.
Kuna mipaka.
Number five, the walls symbolize standards.
Tano, ukuta unashiria viwango.
Standards.
Viwango.
They are national standards.
Kuna viwango vya kimataifa.
They are continental standards.
Kuna viwango vya kimabara.
They are family standards.
Kuna viwango vya familia.
They are individual standards.
Kuna viwango vya bila
standards. None of us shall compromise.
Kwa kuna mmoja wetu atakayekubali.
The Bible demands.
Biblia inaitisha
we establish standards around us.
Ya kusema tuweke viwango kati yetu.
You cannot be a believer who is like a wild plant.
Hawezi kuwa mumini ambao unakaa kama mtu wa kawaida.
You can't be a believer that just lives life like an animal.
Wezi kuwa mtu ambao unaishi tu maisha kama mnyama na wewe ni mumini.
The enemy not will have a place in your life.
Adui atakuwa na sehemu kwa maisha yako.
The Bible says the walls were broken.
Biblia inasema kwamba kuta zilibomoka.
One of the issues that breaks the walls in a believer's life.
Moja wapo vitu ambavyo vinaharibu kuta katika maisha ya mumini.
Sin.
Ni dhambi.
When sin comes.
Wakati dhambi inapoingia.
When sin comes.
Dhambi inapoingia.
When sin comes.
Dhambi inapoingia.
Tell me about neighbor, when sin comes in.
And then tell me, yeah, dhambi inapoingia.
The walls are broken.
Kuta zinabomoka.
The walls are broken.
Kuta zinabomoka.
Somebody say amen.
Tu aseme amen.
So Nehemiah.
When Nehemiah.
When he was seated.
And popa meketi.
The Bible says, she was serving the king.
Biblia inasema kwamba mwana tumikie mfalme.
And he was the top there.
Alikuwa amejibeba kikombe.
In other words, he was the most trusted man in that kingdom. Tell
me, neighbor,
neighbor. You married neighbor. When you married neighbor, tell me, neighbor, you married neighbor. The most trusted man is your wife or your husband.
Somebody
say amen.
Say amen.
Nehemiah. The Bible says,
she
was the cupbearer.
And woman
he tested the wine.
And
if anyone poisoned the wine, then he was the one to die.
Kama mtu angekasumu katika divai yeye angekufa kwanza.
There are men in this church.
Kuna watu katika kanisa hii.
Who can confide in a neighbor?
Ambaye anaweza kubaliana na jirani.
But the wife who handles his life.
Lakini kwa mwanamke ndiye anashikilia maisha yake.
They cannot.
Inawezekana.
They are born again.
Wameokoka.
They are tongue talking.
Wanazungumza kwa ndimi.
They are serving God.
Wanatumikia Mungu.
For them, activity is more important than integrity.
Wao, kazi ni muhimu zaidi kuliko uadilifu.
They can preach like a preach.
Wanaweza kuhubiri vile ninavyohubiri.
They can interpret.
Wanaweza kalimani.
But for them, activity is more than what?
Kazi.
Their principles we learn from Nehemiah. that we need to apply in our lives. When we talk about building the walls, God is calling us to take responsibility.
Mungu anatuita kuwajibika.
I was saying on Friday, most of us, we have lived life that God knows.
When you wish to nation,
God will take care.
Maisha ambayo Mungu atashughulika.
I don't know.
Mimi sijui.
I'll pray about it.
Nitaomba kuhusu hilo jambo.
I'll fast about it.
Nitafunga kuhusu hilo jambo.
God says, yeah.
Mungu anasema ndio.
It's good.
Ni vema.
All those things are good.
Mambo hayo ni mazuri ndio.
But rebuilding.
Lakini kujenga
is about taking charge.
Ni kuhusu kuchukua hatua.
Remember, you take charge.
Ndio kuchukua hatua.
Somebody say amen.
Mtu asema amen.
You cannot control seasons.
Hawezi kuelekeza majira.
You cannot control events around you.
Hawezi kuelekeza matukio.
But you can take charge of your life.
Lakini unaweza ukachukua
hatua. I will not allow the events to affect my life.
Sina kwamba sitaruhusu matukio kuniathiri.
I choose to be strong.
Nachagua kuwa imara.
I choose to focus my life.
Nachagua kuzingatia maisha yangu.
Somebody say amen.
Mtu asema amen.
Tell me about take charge.
Ndio ninachukua usukani.
Take charge.
Chukua usukani.
The question is, who is in charge of your life?
So ni kwamba nani anaelekeza maisha yako?
Is it fact?
Ni hali tu?
Is it demons?
Ni mapepo?
You hear brothers go to pray, or sisters.
Wana ndugu na dada wanaomba.
They take 6 hours casting demons.
Wanachukua masaa 6 kukemea mapepo.
They take 2 minutes glorifying God.
Wanachukua dakika 2 kutukuza Bwana.
The question is, who is in charge of that prayer?
So ni kwamba nani mwenye usukani katika hayo maombi?
See? Who is in charge?
Nani mwenye kukatika usukani?
Taking 6 hours casting demons.
Masaa 6 kukemea pepo.
2 minutes.
Dakika 2.
Thank you, Lord.
Sema asante Bwana.
I bless you. So who is in charge?
Nani anaelekeza?
So remember, there must be a shift.
Nasema kuwe na mabadiliko.
To remember, a shift.
Mabadiliko.
In your prayer life.
Katika maisha yako ya maombi.
In your belief system.
Katika hali yako ya kuamini.
There must be a shift.
Nasema kuwe na mabadiliko.
Somebody say amen.
Mtu asema amen.
There are 10 things I'll mention.
Kuna mambo 10 nitataja.
A few minutes ago,
Nehemiah's
story
about
building the walls. There are principles, 10 of them.
Kuna kanuni kumi.
Number one,
kanuni ya kwanza,
determine your broken walls.
Akusudia,
jua,
ama jua, kuta zako zitabomoka.
Know the walls that are broken in your life.
Elewa kuta ambazo zinabomoka maishani mwako.
Somebody say amen.
Mtu asema amen.
That is the capacity of taking 100% of responsibility.
Hiyo ni hali ya kuchukua asilimia 100 ya kuwajibika.
You must take personal responsibility.
Lazima uchukue wajibu wako mwenyewe.
2022, determine your broken walls.
Elewa kuta zako zilizobomoka.
You cannot change.
Hawezi badilika.
Circumstances around you.
Ama hawezi badilisha hali zinazokuzunguka.
You cannot change.
Hawezi badilisha
the seasons.
Majira.
You cannot stop the wind.
Hawezi kuzuia upepo.
You can change your life.
Unaweza badilisha maisha yako.
Tell the neighbor you can change your life.
Ambia jirani unaweza badilisha maisha yako.
I'm telling this morning.
Ambia siku hii.
You can't change what you're not willing to confront.
Hawezi badilisha kile ambacho hauko tayari kukikemea.
The things that are bitter truths.
Kuna vitu ambavyo ni uchungu mkali.
Na ukweli
mchungu.
You know them.
Unavijua.
Your wife knows them.
Mke wako anavijua.
Your family knows them.
Familia yako inavijua.
Until you're willing to confront.
Hadi uwe tayari kuvikemea.
Then you shall have an answer.
Kisha baadaye utapata jibu.
I don't know what to say amen.
Hakuna mtu atasema amen.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana sifiwe.
Tell your neighbor.
Mwambie jirani.
Confront him.
Ukemea.
You confront it.
Unakikemea.
Praise the Lord.
What is it doing?
Huh? When you realize you are coughing,
ukigundua kwamba unakohoa,
you have less breath,
haupumui vizuri,
you simply confront the issue. I could be COVID positive. Let me go to the doctor.
Unasema tu labda naweza kuwa niko na
corona. Find out.
Niende kwa daktari niambie niko vipi.
Staying in the house,
ukaa katika nyumba,
don't help you.
Haitakusaidia.
You not hear me.
Hujasikia.
So you never leave.
Mwambie jirani.
You can't keep on blaming for all your years.
When you wish to ukilaumu watu miaka yako yote.
I talk to your neighbor, tell your neighbor, neighbor.
Yani,
you can't keep on blaming people all the years.
When you laumu watu miaka yako yote.
You can't keep on blaming events.
Hawezi laumu matukio.
All 2022. 2021 was bad because the weather was bad.
Oh, mwaka jana kwa mbaya sababu hali ya anga ilikuwa mbaya.
Science says if there is no rain coming from up, you can give drip irrigation.
Sema kwamba kama kuna mvua inatoka juu, unaweza fanya kunyunyiza maji.
Oh, the weather.
Sema hali ya anga.
Oh, my father.
Baba yangu.
Oh, my husband.
Mume wangu.
Oh, my children.
Watoto wangu.
Oh, my workplace.
Watu wangu wa kazi.
You have to give up all excuses.
Lazima uachane na visababu vyote.
And be willing.
Na ukusudie.
To determine this is my problem.
Uone kwamba hii ndio shida yangu.
Tell me about neighbor.
Ni jirani.
Stop blaming people.
Anza kuacha kulaumu watu.
Stop blaming politicians.
Acha kulaumu wanasiasa.
When the politicians were fighting in parliament on 27th, the speaker of the National Assembly wrote, and I quote, "Don't blame me.
Usinilaumu mimi.
Garbage in, garbage out. Blame yourself." That's what he says. That I'm not responsible. You are responsible. So whenever you are responsible, I know you cannot say amen. I have no problem.
It's the Shida.
Because I'm speaking what God puts in my heart to tell us. Everything we experience, we shall experience 2022.
Kila kitu ambacho kitapitia 2022
shall gravitate.
Kita
around gravity mikwenda.
Kitazunguka.
Kitazunguka. On the issue, do I know my main problem?
Kitazunguka kwa kitu ambacho ni.
Do I know the, where the broken wall is?
Najua mahali ambapo kuta zimebomoka.
Baba sema amen. The impact you will have in 2022.
Udhuru utakuwa nao mwaka 2022.
It's determined by the choices you make today and yesterday.
Itakuwa kulingana na maamuzi ambayo unafanya leo na kesho.
How will it?
Je, usijini
to determine.
Lazima ukusudie.
Where is my problem?
Kama ujue shida yangu.
Is it economic? How do you spend
money?
Praise the Lord. How do you spend
money?
How do you spend money?
You
can pray. Right now people are harvesting maize. People are eating maize. I go to homes. Somebody has cooked 100 pots of maize.
100.
Watoto wanaogelea. Wanaogelea. Wanaweza enda round. And they go and empty the toilet and come back. Kani kijaa wanaenda kidogo wanarudi. Sema wacha watoto washibe. 2 months on the line.
Miezi miwili baadaye.
We begin buying maize.
Tunaanza kununua maize.
Where is the problem?
Tatizo liko.
Is it God or with us?
Mungu ama ni sisi?
Huh? Praise the Lord.
When I see him.
How is your money?
Pesa zako ziko vipi?
I've known men when they get any money.
Na hiyo watu wao kipata pesa.
They don't know where that money to go to.
How do you tell them that?
One of the most dangerous man is a man who has money but does not know what to use it for.
Mmoja wapo watu hatari ni watu ambao wana pesa lakini hajui kuzitumia.
Anapigia mwili pole.
Anapigia pole.
Baada kutupigia mambo pole anajifurahisha tena. Alafu ya tatu anajispoil. You know, after some time, when I was here, my brother, praise the Lord.
Thanks to your people.
Amen.
Amen.
50. Are you with
me? 50.
You can't imagine the same man.
Where's the figure really into?
The other one I despoil. I said, just eat in the
tea. So that's
just eat. One time I was in Nairobi.
When Nairobi?
And I was having a meeting with some of my young men. In that meeting, all my old friends come who is working in some of the serious organizations. I just taken some fish. I love fish. So, my young man told Pastor, let's go there. They have a place, Samaki Zetus in Apostolic. So, we took Samaki and we ate. The sister comes and says, Pastor, let's go. 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 Let It takes me to one of the best hotels in Nairobi.
The best in Nairobi?
No, at the end of the day, lunch alone. Lunch too. He spent 70,000. You know, he's asking me, are you troubled about it?
Someone at it.
Says money is not problem. But when I look at him,
Wow.
At a nyumba ya 10 by 10 akuna. Okay. Tell your neighbor, you tell me where your problem is. It's true, problem they won't be money.
When I should see pesa.
But it could be priorities.
Labda kuna vitu ambavyo nachagua.
Okay. What else is
here?
Ask the neighbor, how did you spend 2021? I know men who are here, they have, if you want to reach them on call,
kuna watu ambao ukitaka kuwafikia kwa simu,
they have 5 phones.
What is
not right? Five phones.
What a simu time.
Some of them are acting based on who is who.
Wengine wanaangalia nani ni nani.
Not wanaangalia. Namba zimewekwa kwa simu kulingana ile status yako. Sometimes unapata simu yako is engaged.
Simu yake labda iko na mtu.
Ukipiga hii nyingine inaingia, unasema ngojea anarisimu. Anarisimu. No. When you account for all this money in phones, there are around hundreds of thousands.
Pesa zote kwa simu karibu 1100 kama 100,000.
You tell me where the problem is.
Angalia penye shida iko.
Are you struggling over something?
Je, unang'ang'ana juu ya kitu?
Are you struggling over character issue?
Unang'ang'ana juu ya hali ya tabia?
Don't just say it will go.
Sioni kama itaenda.
Determine that 2022,
kufikia 2022,
I'm going to change my response. I'm going to change my life.
Naenda kubadilisha maisha yangu.
You will never rebuild your life.
Hawezi jenga tena maisha yako
until you become, you identify your problem.
Hadi ujue shida yako.
Number 2.
Pili.
Care enough.
Jali sana.
To do something great.
Kutaka kufanya kitu kikubwa.
Care enough to want to do something great.
Jali sana kutaka kufanya kitu kikuu.
Nehemiah became concerned about the walls.
Nehemiah akashughulika sana kwa sababu za kusukuta.
Moses,
nilisema
he broke down.
Nilisema kwamba alivunjika akaenda
chini.
Akaomba.
He fasted.
Akafunga.
He wept.
Akalia.
He cried.
Akalia.
And as he was crying,
alipokuwa kilia,
a burden was developing.
Mzigo ulikuwa unajenga.
The day you change your life,
wakati utakapobadilisha maisha yako,
is the day you change how you respond to situations.
Hapo ndipo utakapobadilisha jinsi unavyozingatia au unapoitikia kwa mambo.
I said, number one, you need to know the ruins, where the ruins are.
Kwanza nimesema kwamba lazima ujue tatizo liko wapi.
You must know.
Lazima ujue
where the problem is.
Hata hapo kuna tatizo.
Number 2, begin to do something great.
Anza kufanya kitu kikubwa.
Have a clear vision.
Kuwa na maono yaliyo safi.
Of what you want to do.
Ya kile ambacho unataka kufanya.
Why you want to do it.
Kwa nini unataka kukifanya.
What do I want to do it.
Je, unataka kukifanya.
How do I want to do it.
Nisafanya namna gani.
Nehemiah sat down.
Na Nehemiah akaketi chini.
I jumped to.
Katika mlango.
Now says he walked.
Biblia inasema.
And went to the king.
Akamwambia mfalme.
Not the king to help him think.
Si mfalme kumsaidia.
He says this is my work plan.
Anasema kwamba huu ni mpango wangu.
He had a clear vision.
Alikuwa na maono safi.
He decided on what he wants to do.
Akakusudia kile cha kufanya.
He knew.
Alijua
that I cannot live my life in the hands of others.
Ya kwamba siwezi ishi maisha yangu kwa mikono ya wengine.
I must set my vision clear.
Lazima nipate maono yangu.
2022.
Mwaka huu.
We must clarify.
Lazima uweke wazi.
You must clarify.
Lazima uweke
wazi. What are you going to do?
Nini utakifanya kufanya?
Is it spiritual?
Je, ni kiroho?
Is it academic?
Je, ni kielimu?
Is it emotional?
Je, ni kihisia?
Is it economic?
Je, ni kiuchumi?
What is it?
Nini hicho
what I want to do?
Ambacho nataka kukifanya.
Somebody say amen.
Tuaseme amen.
Tell your neighbor.
Ni jirani.
Clarify your vision.
Weka wazi maono yako.
Clarify your vision.
Weka wazi maono yako.
People who do great things.
Watu wanaofanya mambo makubwa.
The people
who think big. Ni watu ambao wanafikiria vikubwa.
They have great visions.
Wana maono makubwa.
They think bigger.
Wanafikiria zaidi.
The problem you have in Africa.
Tatizo ambalo tuko nalo Afrika.
The problem you have in the church.
Ama kanisa, tatizo katika kanisa.
We think small.
Tunafikiria tukiu
kidogo.
We achieve what we want to think before we start.
Kisha tunafaulu kile ambacho tunataka kufanya kabla tujaanza.
Oh, it's okay. Bogasa sifa.
Anasifiwa.
Chana leba leba. Ingilani. The greatest danger we have today.
Hatari kubwa tunayo leo.
Talk to them, chana leba leba.
Ingilani.
The greatest danger I have with you.
Kitu langu na wewe.
Is you set very small goals. Very small goals. Very small. That's why you cannot pray. You can't have faith. You can't have faith for small things. You can't have faith for something already there. Set big things. Number three.
Tattoo.
Commit yourself to prayer. Commit yourself to prayer.
Jitolee kwa maombi.
Chapter 1 of Nehemiah verses 5.
Mlango wa kwanza Nehemiah mstari wa 5.
Bible says, and I prayed.
Nikaomba.
Nehemiah prayed.
Nehemiah kaomba.
2022.
Mwaka huu.
We are committing ourselves to prayer.
Tunajitolea kwa maombi.
I told last year about it, we are praying for the nation.
Sema kwamba tunamzigo kuombea taifa.
And this year, when I was waiting on the Lord spoke to me.
Kwa na mgoja kwa na mwaka huu kanyambia.
2022.
Mwaka huu.
We shall have more home cases.
Tutakuwa na kesha nyingi za nyumbani.
Than church cases.
Zaidi ya kesha ya kanisani.
Tell your neighbor.
Ambie jirani.
Open your door.
Fungua mlango wako.
Talk to neighbor. Tell your neighbor. Open your doors.
Fungua mlango wako tu. We
shall have more home cases.
Tutakuwa na kesha nyingi za nyumbani.
We want to build the walls at home.
Tutakuwa tujenge kuta za nyumbani.
We may have one kesha in a month in the church.
Tutakuwa na kesha moja kanisani.
But many of the cases we'll have, I will be from home.
Lakini kesha nyingi itakuwa nazo nyumbani.
I want hopes and leaders to effectively begin working on that program.
Viongozi nyumbani kwanza kwa kushughulikia mpango huo.
We want to have cases.
Nataka tukue na kesha.
On a monthly basis, I want to have 3 cases in the home.
So mwezi mmoja nataka tukue na kesha more tatu.
We go to the instruments.
Bila
we have our mouth.
Tuna midomo.
We want to pray.
Nataka tuombe.
We want to pray.
Nataka tuombe.
From home.
Toka nyumbani.
You did not hear me. God put it above in my heart. I want us to pray from homes. I want us to pray in our clan. The Lord tells me a lot of deliverance must be done from home. We must get back. And we must be willing
to
go in our homes and pray. Somebody say amen. Nehemiah prayed.
Nehemiah kaomba.
He took days.
Alichukua siku kadhaa.
He took 3 months of praying and fasting.
Miezi tatu akiomba na kufunga.
And after that,
baada ya hayo,
he rose and began to do something.
Aliinuka sasa kufanya kitu.
Prayer,
maombi,
is the key.
Ni ufunguo wa ubinyenzo.
Prayer,
maombi,
is the currency by which we transact the kingdom issues.
Ni namna ambayo tunafikia vitu vya mbinguni.
Prayer initiates fulfillment of God's agenda in our lives.
Maombi yanazalisha kusudi la Mungu katika maisha yetu.
When we pray,
tunapoomba,
prayer insists on the promises of God.
Maombi yanatoka kwa ahadi za Mungu.
Prayer makes the vision clear.
Maombi yanafanya maono
clear. The more we pray,
zaidi tunavyoomba,
the vision becomes clear.
Maombi yanakuwa wazi zaidi.
God may give you a small, it may give you an idea.
Unaweza nipatie wazo.
But the more you pray over it, the more the vision becomes bigger and becomes wider, and God begins to move you. Prayer moves us into action. It doesn't just help us, it changes us into action. I want church to pray. I told one of the bugs I have from January, Monday.
Mojawapo ya mizigo ambayo tunayo kuanzia January Monday.
We are adopting the morning devotions.
Tunaingia katika maombi ya asubuhi.
From 5 to 6.
Kuanzia saa 11 hadi
saa 5. By 5.
Kanisa linafungua saa 11.
Between 5 and 6 we are praying.
Kati ya saa 11 saa 12 tunaomba.
Monday to Friday.
Kuanzia Jumatatu hadi Ijumaa.
God wants to do something.
Mungu anataka afanye jambo.
Tell your neighbor, neighbor.
Hadi jirani.
Prayer is a catalyst.
Maombi.
Prayer is a catalyst.
Maombi.
Prayer is a catalyst.
Maombi.
Prayer is a catalyst.
Nehemiah
prayed.
Nehemiah niomba.
He stood by the promises.
Alisimama kwa ahadi.
And says, you, O Lord,
asema, hey, Bwana,
who remembers mercy to thousands and thousands of generations.
Ambao unakumbuka rehema kwa vizazi.
You spoke to Moses.
Ulizungumzia Musa.
You spoke to Abraham.
Ukazungumzia Abraham.
Lord, you spoke to your prophets.
Bwana ukazungumzia manabii.
This is what's going to happen.
Hiki kitu kitakachotokea.
He reminded God of his promises. Prayer is reminding God what he has said. What has God said about you? What has God promised you? What are the promises that God made to you 20 years ago? You stand by them and say, Lord, you said. It is holding God and his character. You hold his character, his nature. You say, Lord, you said. You are the same yesterday, today, and forever. Lord, do something this way. And I'm telling God, we'll do it in Jesus. Someone say amen. Number four, seek proper authority to act.
Nehemiah,
he's anointed. He has received a heavenly call to do something. But he just doesn't go. He goes back to the king and says, Bwana King, this is the year of. Please permit me. And the king says, I will go. I will allow you. And the king says, how long? And Nehemiah gives the time span. Because he knew what he wants to
do.
Friends, we need to seek clear authority. You may have the power. You may have the anointing. But the things in the spiritual realms cannot deal with. Unless you seek authority from above. Because demons know authority. They know. Once they know, pastor is standing behind this thing, the devil will do nothing. He can walk around, he can bring a lot of challenges, but they know authority. There are things in his spiritual authority. There are things in his secular authority. You need to do it. That's why I'm very enthusiastic. I've kept on telling some members of this church in 2027, I need to have members of parliament from this church. I need to have a member of parliament. I need to have an MCA. I need to have an administrator. But in Maseno Town, who stands as a trader, chairman of Maseno Traders, who will call for a meeting and say, let us pray? No traders. Who trade on the same traders? Traders, when they see you have opened a new shop in Maseno, and because every stock, they organize the tax in Maseno, and they come and steal from you. We are saying no to them in Jesus' name. I say we are saying no to them. We want leaders. Those who are in education system, we want administrators. Those who are in the university, I need guys, my desk, a phone call says, we can have a prayer meeting at the dean's office. This thing must consult and we talk about it. I need guys who shall be in the security.
What about to ask for leads?
Key leaders.
What to a cool?
Because your neighbor. Authority. I need a chief.
I need a sub chief.
So that when you want to transact an issue, chief at a Pambia calamity, you need 20,000. You'll go there and say, hallelujah, praise the Lord. Thank you, my sister. Thank you. You are a blessing in this office. We pray. Sama, na kuandikia enda. See, hii kalamu ya shamba ni shilingi ya elfu hamsini. Kalamu gani Kenya inauza shilingi? Ni waiburu ama ni nani? Kwa maana hiyo ndio zilikuwa zinauzwa that time. You know, we need these guys with us. How somebody is developing a body? How somebody is developing a body?
Praise
the Lord. People will demystify some of these offices. Instead of saying that at politics is a dirty game, they shall be there and say, I am an example of a godly end. Somebody say amen. Tell your neighbor. Seek authority. Clear authority. Clear authorities. God raise up authorities in Jesus' name. Raise up authorities in this church. Raise up authorities in this land. Raise up authorities in various sectors in Jesus' name. Let our sons and daughters become a voice in
in their generation.
Somebody say amen.
Somebody say
amen.
Number five. Don't be surprised by the opposition that will come your way. Don't be surprised by the opposition that comes your way. Every godly assignment will always attract resistance. I repeat, every godly assignment will attract demonic resistance. They will resist you.
Okay, yet we're having some prayer move somewhere.
The whole night I was coughing. My temperature was abnormal. My headache was busting out. And I told God, I must do this thing. We have been preparing. We have been praying. Even if I'm given and I'm pretending to that one, every godly assignment will attract demonic opposition. There's
a
Sanballat rose up. Sanballat. He knows how, and you can fight Nehemiah.
One of
the things they will do, they will ridicule you.
What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing?
Nehemiah throughout the 52 days.
Nehemiah anachukua siku 52.
He remained focused on God.
Anatazamia Mungu.
He prayed to him.
Anamwomba Mungu.
He worshiped him.
Anamwabudu Mungu.
He served him.
Anamtumikia Mungu.
He did everything to God.
Akamfanyia kila kitu.
And beyond that,
zaidi ya hayo,
he remained focused on the assignment.
Bado alizingatia kazi yake.
He said, I will be there.
Anasema nitakuwa pale.
I will supervise.
Nitaangalia.
I will do it.
Nitaifanya.
Remain focused.
Hadi nizingatie tu.
Kama usia mimi.
Mtu asina mina.
Tena leba remain focused.
Ndiye jirani zingatia.
Remain focused.
Zingatia.
Remain focused.
Zingatia.
Be there.
Kuwa pale.
On your assignment.
Kwa kazi yako.
Don't build a house when you are in Maseno. You are building a house in Kisumu.
Usijenge nyumba Kisumu na uko Maseno.
Go there.
Nenda pale.
Sababu simiti ngapi zinatumiwa kila siku.
Hallelujah.
Kama uko pale.
Kama uko hapo.
Unajua ni simiti ngapi. Na natoa kosel ngapi za matofali na za blocks. Simiti tatu natoa kosel ngapi. Unajua.
Unajua.
Umekubalikia. Lakini, pastor tumetengeneza kosel sita. Tumetumia simiti mzuri sana. Baba sikuni. Okay. Nehemiah was there to supervise.
Nehemiah was there to supervise.
He was hands on.
Alikuwa pale pengine mikono.
So remember, remain focused on God.
Zingatia kwa Mungu kujiona
ni agenda
pamoja na kazi yake.
Remember boss agenda has a time span.
Kuna kumbuka kwamba kazi ya Mungu ina wakati wake.
Nehemiah built the walls for 52 days.
Nehemiah akajenga ukuta kwa siku 52.
Remain focused.
Zingatia.
Psalm 7.
Ndosema mimi.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana sifiwe.
Second last.
Karibu mwisho.
Learn the principle of accountability.
Jifunze kanuni za kuwajibika.
Be accountable.
Ajibika kwa uchoyo sana.
To your partner.
Kwa mwenzako.
To your family.
Kwa familia yako.
To your pastor.
Kwa mchungaji wako.
Lastly.
Mwisho.
Finish what you start.
Kamilisha kila ambacho ulianzisha.
Finish what you start.
Kamilisha ulichokianzisha.
Nehemiah within 52 days.
Nehemiah kwa siku 52.
The Bible says.
Biblia inasema.
He finished the works.
Alimaliza zile kuta.
And after finishing the works.
Baada ya kumaliza kuta.
They were finished and they celebrated.
Zilikamilika wakasherehekea.
I want to challenge us this morning.
Nataka tuambiwe siku hii.
Whatever you begin to do.
Kila ambacho ulianza kukifanya.
2022.
Mwaka 2022.
Finish it.
Kikamilishe.
Psalm 7.
Nasema mimi.
Finish what you begin.
Kamilisha kila ambacho umeanzisha.
Tell me about finish what you begin.
Ambia jirani kamilisha kila ambacho umeanzisha.
Tell me about finish what you begin.
Kamilisha kila ambacho umeanzisha.
Psalm 7.
Mtu asema mimi.
Finish what you begin.
Kamilisha ulichokianzisha.
Finish what you begin.
Kamilisha ulichokianzisha.
Finish.
Kamilisha.
Finish.
Kamilisha.
May God give us a grace.
Mungu atupe neema.
To go through 2022.
Kupita katika mwaka huu.
May God give us a grace in Jesus name.
Mungu atupe neema katika jina la Yesu.
Psalm 65 verse 11 the Bible says.
Zaburi 65 verse 11.
Psalm 65 verse 11.
Zaburi 65
verse 11. Psalm 65 verse 11.
Zaburi 65 verse 11.
Psalm 65 verse 11.
Zaburi 65 verse
11. What does the Bible says?
Biblia inasema namna gani?
You crown the year with your goodness.
Unaufika mwaka kwa taji ya wema.
You are path drink with abundance.
Mapato yako yatadoza maono.
May God come your year 2022.
Mungu akuvize
with his goodness in Jesus.
Kwa wema katika jina la Yesu.
May your path drink with abundance.
Wacha njia zako zikajaa wema tena.
I say the Lord come your year with goodness.
Mungu akuvize mwaka kwa wema na
mema. Let's stand up before the Lord. Father, crown my year with goodness.
Bwana ufike mwaka wangu kwa wema.
Father, crown my path with the prince of abundance.
Jaza njia zangu kwa utele.
Father, crown my year.
Uvishe mwaka wangu
goodness.
Kwa wema.
Yes, thank you, yes.
Inua mikono kwa Bwana.
In the name of Jesus.
Kwa jina la Yesu.
Yes, lift up your hands and say, God, crown my year.
Bwana ufike mwaka wangu.
With your goodness.
Kwa wema.
We hear your voice. Crown my ear with your goodness. Let my path dream with abundance. 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 Let my path dream with abundance.
So
lift up your hands to the Lord and say, Lord, crown my ear with your goodness.
Crown
my ear 2022.
Uvike mwaka mpya
your goodness.
Kwa wema.
With
your goodness. Asante ya wema.
Crown my year with your goodness.
Uvike mwaka wako.
Crown my year with your goodness.
Asante ya wema kwa Mungu.
Crown my year with your goodness.
Asante ya wema kwa Mungu.
Crown my year with your goodness.
Asante ya wema kwa Mungu.
Let me pray.
Baba,
crown my year with your goodness.
Uvike mwaka wako kwa
Mungu. Let the goodness of the Lord.
Wacha wema wako.
Ama shadow me.
Ukanipite.
Ama shadow me.
Ukanifunike.
Thank you. How many are ready to sing with me?